Hello traders, welcome back to my channel and to a new Sierra Chart trading tutorials and tips video series. Again, if you haven't done so, make sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on any new content coming out every week. As well too, on the pinned message in the video description, I have a link for my entire Sierra Chart tutorial playlist here on YouTube. I've made over probably 20 videos by now of Sierra Chart tutorials, so I'm sure you're going to find a lot of useful information there. Today is going to be a pretty quick and basic video for a function that is very easily found in platforms like TradingView, but on Sierra Chart it requires a specific study or indicator for it. I'm talking about these session break lines. So what does that mean? Well, for example, here we have an S&P 500 1 hour chart, and as you can see, there's nothing marked on it. So I do have the dates down here at the bottom, but I would like to have vertical lines signaling where each trading day starts. So TradingView is very simple. There's a couple of ways you can do that. The fastest way is if you go down into the timeline here and you right click, there's a little shortcut here. You can't see it because of the bottom of the video here, but there's a shortcut here. If you right click down over here, there's a menu that comes up, and down below it says session breaks. If you click that, then you can see that you get the lines here showing up. Or the other way to get there is just either go to the gear icon on the top right corner right here, or you can just right click your mouse and then go to settings, then go to appearance, and you can see right here there's an option that says session break. So if I click that, that is going to enable session breaks. I can change the color, I can make it darker, I can make it into a dash, I can make it into a straight line, etc. And so once I do that, then you can see that now it's very easy to see. Let me zoom in so you can see it, and let me make them into solid lines. So you can see right there very easily all the lines where each session starts. This is futures, so this is at 6 p.m. Eastern time, the beginning of every trading day. So how do we do this in Sierra Chart? Okay, so for that, let's go into Sierra. This is the same S&P chart. It's a 1 hour e-mini chart. And as you can see, the only thing I have marked here is the current price line, but I don't have any divisions here. You can see each trading day starts here on the black labels, but I don't have anything here. So in order to put this in Sierra, you need to go to analysis, click studies. This is going to bring you the whole list of indicators that's available. Go to the T and go where it says timeline. Click on it, then click add. And now you can see it's going on your right side. If you click apply, you can see that now it is applied and you have solid lines indicating your timeline. If you want to customize them, just make sure it is highlighted. Click settings. This is going to bring the study settings here. And what I like to do is, first of all, I give it a short name or a nickname, so that way I can distinguish from my list of indicators which one this is exactly. So I'm going to put, let's put daily open. Okay. And then over here, time of line. Depending what market you're trading, this is going to vary. But like I said, I'm in the Eastern time zone in the US, and I'm trading in this case futures. So I'm going to put 1800 hours, which is 6 p.m. Eastern, which is the start of each trading day for futures. Allowed day of week. Here you can even choose a specific day to put it in. I just put all days. I click apply. And now you can see if I go out, all the lines have shifted, and now I have a new line starting at 6 p.m. every day, marking where the session begins. Now, if I want to customize these lines, I again just go to analysis studies. I click on the daily open. As you can see now, it is showing. It says the indicator name, but before that, it says the nickname I gave it, which is daily open. So it's just a lot easier to distinguish what it is. I go to settings, and then over here, I go to the subgraphs tab, and the first option right here, timeline SG1. This is the one that we're going to be paying attention to customize. Right over here, first option, the draw style, just leave it at bar top. The line style, it's set to solid now. I like to put dot just so it's less distracting, and I leave it at a width of one. So if I click apply, now you can see I have the lines, but they're in dashes. And I generally, the color here, I like to use a little lighter gray. I basically like to have my timelines, my session starts very subtle, so the chart doesn't look very messy. So something like that is good. So then I click, oh, this is just a personal choice, but down here, you can see all these things are checked off. This means that you have this label over here showing all these values at the top of the chart. I like to just take this off. This is personal preference because I like to keep this as clean as possible. And pretty much that's it. I just click OK, OK. And now you can see I have my my E-mini SP500 1 hour chart. And even if I change time frames to whatever time frame I want, these lines are always going to be there now, every day at the beginning at the 6 p.m. Eastern time. And again, you can customize it to whatever market you want, whatever time, whatever color, type of line, etc. Okay, so that's pretty much how you set up your session or daily start line on any market in Sierra Chart. Thank you for tuning in. Hope this video has been helpful, and have a great day, and I'll see you all in the next video. Take care.